All right, Moses, I'm back. Did you miss me? No.
We almost came to blows, speaking of hockey fights anyways.
Yeah, he was making fun of the Oilers, and then, well, not so much making fun, but I returned after seeing the Orange and Blue live last night.
I'm beginning to think that, you know, since you've had season tickets, the team has not made the postseason. Just saying.
Technically, it's been a little less than 7, but I could very well be the reason why the team does not win. Who knows? But I'm back there on Monday, so we'll see if I am bad luck or not. So anyway, let's talk hockey.
Yes.
And our Lloydminster Bobcats, like, if you cannot make it out to Oiler games, of course, our local team is just kicking some butt right now to start off the season.
Doing very well, of course, familiar foes. At the RJ Lalonde last night, they renewed their little rivalry. Of course, I'm talking about the Lloydminster Bobcats making the trek to Bonneville. Take on the Pontiacs. The Yaks taking the first two contests this year. Bobcats still on a roll, like you say, Naren, winning 4 of their last 5 games. So in the first, Bobcats up 1-0. Mitch Fritz crashes the net, ties it up at 1 after 20. So late in the second, the Yaks will take the lead. Redford Swan just throws it on net and scores. His first of the season, home side up a goal. 59 seconds later, Mitch Brennan, the Bobcat rookie defenseman, he scores his first AJHL goal. We're tied up at 2 after 2. So to the final period, Bonneville runs into some penalty trouble and the Orange and Black capitalize. Lennon Springer, best flow in the league, also going to add a goal to his resume. That would be the game winner. The Bobcats win 5 of their last 6. Ponce drop 4 of 5.
Got 6 games on the road, and we know that we've got to maintain our foundation of work ethic and compete, and then stick to our process throughout those 60 minutes. And we know we've got the right players in the dressing room there to be able to get that done.
You know what? We started out good. We were out playing them. We played good the whole game, and then as we got to the end, we kind of fell apart a little bit. Didn't stick to our structure and kind of cost us in the end.
You looked at the first period, 5-5 in shots, and the second period, not much better. And then they're a team that's on a roll. They've got a lot of confidence, and they're playing the way that they need to with the personnel that they've got.
The Lloydminster Baker Hughes Bobcats open up the 2013-14 campaign with a couple of wins last weekend. And as Matt Schumont reports, solid play, particularly from the rookies, has been a big boost.
The Baker Hughes Bobcats started the season on a high note with a pair of home wins, satisfying head coach Cole Fisher.
Overall, I got the effort that I wanted, and we got a lot of pucks on net. Could have maybe put a few more in the back of the net, but the overall prognosis is it was a positive weekend for us.
You know, I thought we played good. We played tough, good third period. You know, we didn't back down. Even if we got ahead a little bit, we kept an even keel. So, yeah, thought we did pretty good.
In those two games, the play of the 4 15-year-olds was noticeable, playing good in all zones and also getting their name on the score sheet.
I was just trying to get my feet wet, get used to the pace of the game, and fortunately I got a couple goals, but I was just looking to give a performance, create some offense, and just be strong on my own end.
Try to do everything simple, not to do too much by my own, but yeah, move the puck around and hope things went my way.
The Bobcats will play just the one game this weekend, and after allowing 4 goals in the first two games, defense will remain the focus for this week of practicing.
The D-zone breakdowns we had last weekend and some of those little things that the system stuff that, you know, you got to get out of the way at the start of the year and make sure everybody's on the same page.
You cannot never be good enough in your defensive zone, so and just lots of communication, and I think we'll be set to go.
Matt Schumont, Newcap Sports.
The Lloydminster Universal Heat are torching the net, lighting the lamp 39 times in just 4 games. Matt Schumont tells us that the Heat will hope to keep that momentum going with a pair of home games this weekend.
It's a story that's starting to get all too familiar as the Heat improved to 4-0 over the weekend and now have outscored their opponents 39-6.
Just keeping it simple, the boys are keeping it simple and shooting pucks on net, and right now it's fine in the back of the net, so we can be happy about that. Obviously you're going to go through stretches where you're scoring a lot of goals and sometimes you're not going to be scoring, but we'll take this right now and keep working hard.
We're really coming together. I think 2 good games, really battled hard, putting a good effort, and we came out with the win.
In the Heat's 4 victories, the duo of Zane Franklin and linemate Bryce Kindop have combined for an astonishing 29 goals and 36 points.
I think communication is a big part of it, and talking on the bench and talking on the ice. and just having a good feeling for each other on the ice, and I think that's a big part of what we've done.
We really talk often, or on the ice and off the ice. We just get things going and we find each other really easily.
The Heat now prepare for what will be the toughest test of the season, and after allowing some goals on the penalty kill, that will be the focus as they get ready for the weekend.
We gave up three power play goals on Sunday, so you know there's something there to work on. You know, you're never satisfied, you know. You got to keep working hard, especially this early in the season. There's lots to work on, and we'll just keep plugging away and just getting better every day. That's our motto, kind of, is every day we're at the rink, we're getting better, and the boys have bought in, and they've been working hard so far this year.
Matt Schumont, New Cap Sports.